Hello everyone, myself Mrunalini Garud from KKW College of Agricultural Biotechnology, Nasik, Maharashtra. Today I am going to introduce the DNA barcoding database, that is BOLD. Before going towards how to use this BOLD database and how can we identify the different species, we should know what is DNA barcoding databases. As we know, the barcoding is nothing but it is a code for identification. It is a pattern of identification like this. This is a barcoding. Like this, DNA barcoding database is also a code or identification pattern for different species. So let's start with the introduction of DNA barcoding. So what is DNA barcoding? DNA barcoding is a method of identifying organisms based on a short standardized fragments of genomic DNA and has been developed for use by taxonomists, ecologists, conservation biologists, regulatory agencies and other scientists or other researchers. This DNA barcoding is a method where we can identify the different species by using a short section of DNA from a specific gene or genes. Then this DNA barcodes can be used to identify unknown species also, or parts of an organism, or simply it can to catalog as many as takes as possible, or to effort to determine the species boundary. Likewise, DNA barcoding is nothing but it is a method where the genomic DNA or short fragment of DNA is used to identify the unknown species. Here we can see these are the species, then DNA, and this is the barcode of particular species. There are some common regions present on the gene which can be used for barcode. If it is animal or protist, then you can use cytochrome C oxidase, or which is gene found in specially mitochondrial DNA. If it is fungus, then you can use internal transcribed spaces. If it is a plant, then you can use Rubisco, MATK, RDCL gene. If it is on large scale, you have to identify whether the new species is from prokaryote or eukaryote. Then for prokaryote, you can use the region of 16S rRNA, and for eukaryote, you can use for 18S rRNA region. These are some common barcodes which are used for DNA barcoding. This is a simple method, diagrammatical representation of DNA barcoding. First, you have to extract the DNA of method, DNA extraction. Then, the amplification of DNA to produce a million of copies. For this, you can use the PCR method, different methods of PCR. Then, the barcode. The pattern produced create a unique barcode. Here the unique barcode code is given to that particular sequence. Then the result of barcode is inputted in BOLD database or BOLD system. At this stage, we can consider the DNA barcode database BOLD is nothing but it is a library where the all results of barcoded patterns are inserted or included. This is a library. Okay, then here is this is a simple method or protocol of DNA barcoding. Then there are some applications of DNA barcoding. Likewise, identification of species. By using the DNA barcoding method, we can identify the species or by using a short DNA sequence or marker from standardized region of the genome. Then for detection of invasive species, or for delimiting cryptic species, or for diet analysis and food web application. Here you can use a sequencing for stomach content, which can be done by DNA barcoding. And for food safety, the example of food safety, we can distinguish between the poisonous mushroom and edible mushroom. Then for ecological assessment, by DNA barcoding method, we can assess the presence of endangered species for the conservation effort. This is an important part of DNA barcoding. Also, we can verify the presence of indicator species which are reflecting to specific ecological condition also. These are the most important applications of DNA barcoding method. Then, let's start the DNA barcoding database, that is the BOLD system. Let's start with its introduction. BOLD is nothing but it is a barcode of life data system. And this method or this database is developed by Dr. Paul Herbert and his team at the University of Ghost in 2003. This is nothing but this is a freely available, anyone can access this database who have the interest in computational biology or bioinformatics and want to know what is the pattern or barcode of particular species, he can use anywhere. This is informatic workbench which aiding the acquisition, storage, analysis and publication of DNA barcode records. Nowadays, the consortium for the barcode of life, that is CBOL, it was launched in near about 2004 and it includes near about 120 organizations with 45 nations. This is the highest record or recent records of BOLD. Then once the result is inserted in a BOLD, this result or a copy of all sequences and key specimens data is also migrate to NCBI or its sister genomic repository, that is DDBJ and EMBL. This is a short introduction of BOLD database. While accessing the user BOLD database, there are some troubleshoots for public search like spelling mistake or additional space, or if you are using some specific domain code for narrow result, it should be accurate for more accuracy of result. These are some troubleshoots for public search. This is a URL for a BOLD database which can be used for access the BOLD database, and this is a home page. Okay, so let's start how to access this BOLD database and what are its properties which can be used for new users. Let's start it. BOLD database. Okay, this is a URL of BOLD and click on BOLD system. Okay, this is the URL. Sorry, this is a home page of BOLD, that is barcode of life data system. Then here we can see these are the some short data portal, educational portal, then BIN databases and workbench. We will see one by one. Here on upper side we can see there are different tools present on BOLD system. If you are a new for a BOLD system, then you should go for educational portal. If you click on educational portal, this is an overview of educational portal. This is nothing but for student data portal for new user. Here we can see student data portal. Here is a system overview. System overview is a whole brochure, informative brochure for student. This is a whole brochure for BOLD system, how to access and what are the features of that BOLD database. Then you want a quick start guide, you should go for here, where if you click on any option you get instant information of BOLD system. Then there are some tutorials which are maybe very informative for student, like how to register an account, then how to submit your data, and the courses which are included in BOLD system for student. This is the overview. Then there is a video introduction of BOLD system also, which gives the informative information for student. This is of student homepage. where you can identify or you get some frequently asked questions also. Okay, this is a student portal. Then I start with how to data portal. What is a data portal? Click on databases. Here we can see public data portal, BIN databases, publication and primary databases. If you click on public data portal, if you want to search the species information, you should go for public data portal. Like if you want to study Drosophila, got spelling mistake. This is Drosophila. You can find there is no match for this. That's I have told previously that there is, if you have any spelling mistake, you didn't get any proper result. Okay, here is your result. We have inserted Drosophila. We found different results or records which are included in our BOLD system. Here we get the published records, then with records with sequence, then BIN clusters like this. Here we get this specimen distribution all over world. This is the specimen distribution. Then in data summary, these are the institutes which contributed for this data submission. The countries, these are the countries from where these species are collected. Then in Drosophila, these are different species of same family but with different taxa. Then genera is Drosophila. Then it is a family, order, BIN clusters. For more specification result, here we can save this file in FASTA format also or XML format also. For more specification result, click on any one of these. Here we can see the different specific result of our species. The sample ID, field ID, then deposited in American type culture collection. Then the attributions, this is taxonomical classification of our query. Then specimen details, collection details, from where it is collected, publication. Then the sequence, this is sequence information. Then genome is from mitochondrial which is collected. It's a gene bank accession number here. This is a barcode of the particular species. This can be view the file in computer readable format also. So this is the result how we can use this data for public data search. Okay. Now for BIN database. If you are searching for Coleoptera, BIN is nothing but barcode index number system, cluster sequence. This is algorithm process. This is the result of BIN. Here also we can see this is a specimen distribution all over the world. Then same the institutions, countries and species, these are the results. If we click on here, we can see the order is Coleoptera, then species. There are number of species in the that Coleoptera. Here we can see its images. Click on any one, the opening is, this is the code, bold code of that particular species. Here we can see this is a specific result. This is the image, then it's a code. Here are different neighboring species, then taxonomical identification, taxonomical details of that particular species, then attributions, publications of that on that particular species. Then this is a haplotype network, like this is a haplotype network which contributed different countries. Then collection of that particular species are from Canada and US. These are some data managers for data public and private data, the name of that data managers. This is BIN detail of this particular species. Then on publication, if you click on publication, you can identify or save the different files of that species publication, the scientists, researchers who have published their data. Like we are using our PubMed database, like this we can use this publication site also. For primer database, if you want to know which primer can be used for that particular species identification, you should go for primer search for PCR. Click here. Click the species name or what you want to search. If you click on anyone, the name of submitter and reference of this primer. Okay. Click anyone, then you can download this selected primer also. Here we can see our FASTA, our primer sequence. Open with notepad. This is our primer. Okay. Likewise, we can download the different primers for our specific species or organism. This is one of two. Then you can identify the different databases. Also you can go for taxonomical identification. Then if you have to log in or you have your username, you can log in. There are different resources by which we can use this BOLD database. These are the different resources of frequently asked questions, then the handbooks of different versions of BOLD databases. Then you can log in this page. If you are new, you can create a new account, or you, if you have your own username and password, you can log in this page and you can work, or you can upload your data in Workbench. Now, if you want to identify the unknown species of any particular animal or plant species, then how can you identify? Click on this identification, you get this result where you can identify animal, fungal identification and plant identification. Here it is, it has given the specific barcode regions. If you have any FASTA sequence, I have already, this is unknown, we don't know of what class this is, this species. Then all barcode records, this is the FASTA. Click copy paste your FASTA sequence, then submit your result. Consuming. Okay, this is our identification result. Our sequence was unknown, we don't know of what species it is a FASTA sequence. Here we can see the query ID was unlabeled sequence. Okay, then the identified result is of Drosophila. Here we get the name of that particular species of sequence. Then this is the result. Here we get the different matches, like matches of that particular sequences, the details of published data. Then this is the site where the sample was collected in the BOLD database. I have told this is BOLD is nothing but it is a library where the barcode records are recorded or maintained. Here we can see on our query sequence, these are the different locations from where this BOLD records are collected. If we click on tree, you get a PDF tree or taxonomical reports, the in where the taxonomical importance are included. Then you can go for image list also, the different match spaces we can view here. Likewise, this is the tree view. Then this result can be downloaded, like here we can download here or print here. So by using this database identification, we can identify the unknown species. If you have its own FASTA sequence, then you can conclude from which species or from which genera or order it is included, what's its family. Likewise, you can go for search tool also directly. So this is all about how to work with BOLD database and how can be used for identification. Okay, hope this video will helpful for the students who are interested in bioinformatics and who want to know what is the DNA barcoding database. It is surely helpful. Thank you. So guys, thank you. Hope you have watched my previous video on the topic, that is biogrid database. Hope you enjoyed and you like this video.